Hi guys, Codetutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande.
This is the last video on the concept of broadcast receivers, where I am going to talk about some of the nuances that you have to be aware while using the broadcast receiver in your application. One of the very first points that I want to talk about is that it runs on the main thread or the UI thread. This could be a counterintuitive for most of the people because broadcast receiver doesn't have any UI. So you may think that the broadcast receiver is getting executed on some other worker thread. That is not the case. If you do it wrongly, then it can lead to an application not responding error. To understand this and drive home this particular point, I will quickly get into a demo. I'm using one of the previous projects that I have used in the previous videos. As you can see, I have an activity here. On click of this particular button, I am triggering the intent, and the intent is broadcast. Here, I am showing the thread ID. What I am doing is, as activity gets started, I am triggering the thread ID, and when my broadcast receiver gets triggered, I am once again toasting the thread ID. If both of them are running on the same thread, which in this case is the main thread, then you should get the thread ID as one and the same, both in the main activity and in the broadcast receiver. I will launch the app, and you can see main activity thread ID is 1. And when I click on this particular button, the toast once again displays the thread ID as 1. So the broadcast receiver runs on the main thread. And that is why Android recommends that the broadcast receiver should not do anything which takes more than 10 seconds. And next important point is, when broadcast receiver completes the onReceive method execution, it is considered to be finished. This has a serious implication in the way you would use a broadcast receiver. Typically, you implement a broadcast receiver and override the onReceive method. Assume that you have started the execution of the onReceive method, and somewhere in between, you basically want to connect to a remote service, that is, you want to bind to a service. But by the time service returns back, broadcast receiver will complete its execution and the onReceive method will complete it. So that is why broadcast receiver is not suited for the asynchronous calls, and never bind to a service from the broadcast receiver. But however, you can start a service from a broadcast receiver. The broadcast receivers are prone to hacks, and thus you should always secure them. There are two simple ways of securing them. One is set exported attribute to false. Another way is use the local broadcast manager to limit the intent propagation beyond the app. Both of these two simple methodologies I have explained in previous videos. With this, it is a curtain closure for the discussion of broadcast receiver on Codetutor as of now. The next topic that I would be discussing is content provider.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.